Hi, John Wales here. Today's VideoPad 5-Minute Friday is going to be about using the split screen that's built into the VideoPad. It's a very simple effect to use, and what I'm going to try and do is split this screen in half. And now on that side, you should be seeing me making a cup of coffee at home just before I go into the spare room, boot up the computer, get onto the editor and show you how this is done. So if there's anything you enjoy about this video, don't forget, thumbs up. And later on, I'm also going to put on the other bit, or better still, subscribe and click this notification bell and you'll get all of my upcoming videos. So let's get and do some editing. To try and keep in my time scale, I've opened up VideoPad. I've brought in three sections of film. I've pulled three sections of film onto different timelines. I've called one video A, one video B, one video C. That's always handy to do just to keep track of your videos. Now, first thing we're going to do, I'm going to come down to video A, and on the video track, not the audio track, I've taken all the audio off of this to make life easier. Click on the FX button on the video track, come up to the plus button, hit plus, and here in motion and transforms, drop down and you'll find somewhere there split screen, click on that. And what that does, here's your split screen. This is basically your frame. And in this occasion, it's broken up into three sections. And down here, you can change the layout and you can make it 2x2 sections, or I don't know, 3x5 sections. You can see what I mean. You can see where I'm going. But I'm gonna come back up here, hit horizontal 3. To me, that's vertical, but it says horizontal on there. So that's what I'm gonna work with. Pretty much what we do in here, if I click that there, video A, I want to show up on this section as video A. Close that. Here on video B, here's the video track, click on FX. Again, come up to your plus box, drop down to split screen. And now I want this section of film to show up in the middle of the frame, so click B. And I want to do the same now with the last one, which is C, video track C. Here's the video, here's my FX box, click that. Come up here to plus, drop down here, find split screen. And now if I click on C, I have now put the relevant bits of film into the relevant section of the frame that I wanted to go on. If I close that, enlarge this, and then press play. So I have to sync a little bit at the start, but if I press play, you'll see what's happened. And there we go. So that's as easy as that to split your screen. Something that you can do, and which you might want to do if you are going to use split screen, what you can do, you might find like this where I'm walking out of focus here, because what it's done, it's obviously split each of these video tracks, it split them into three as well. So if, for instance, here's video track C, which is this one here on the right, if I click back on the FX box, move it over here so we can see what's going on. Here below the layout region resizing, down here you get horizontal base, higher horizontal bias. If you watch this section of film over here, where I'm in the kitchen, and I move the horizontal bias, you can see exactly what it's doing. Pretty much what it's doing, the piece of film, it's moving it underneath or across, in or out, so you can adjust your focus on where you want it to be. So I'd want to be, say, more there in line. I close that, I press play and see what happens. And then more or less, I'm pretty much gonna stay in the center of the picture, like that. Another little thing I'm gonna show you, which is very handy to do. So I've shown you how to split the screen, which is dead easy. Something else that's nice, if you hit the add text button, drop down here on the add text, you've got quite a few things you could pick from, but down here it says drawing. Here, drawing vertical, if you click on that, what that will do is, move that the way, that will bring you up a vertical line. You just see it there. I am going to adjust the length of this vertical line box to match the length of the film, like that, pretty much. Come on, trying to keep this in real time. Let me just move this over here a bit. Then if you come back here and press add edit, what that does, your vertical line, you can change that a little bit, especially here, you can do the line width. If I increase the line width. As you see, it grew in width there. And then the other thing, you have horizontal offset. And this is cool because you can drag it across and you can get it to split the sections up. So I'll move that across there. I'll do nice on that. Then I will add another add text. Come back down, vertical, click on there. I'm going to move that red line up the way, but I'm going to match the length of my film with the vertical line. Click on there. Once again, let's enlarge that over to this side. Here's the new line. As you can see, it's quite thin. Same again. Edit your text. Click on that. Here's the line width, because now we're working on the line, remember, not the picture. Increase it a little bit. Too much. Reduce a bit. And that's about the same as the last one. And then on the horizontal offset, move them across. So that splits up the second and the third section. Like that. I'll close that. Move this across. Let's go back to the start. Press play. And then you've got the lines that just drop down there. You can play around with them to get them absolutely perfect, but it just gives that little bit more of a professional look, and it highlights the sections better than if they're not there. So I'm hoping I've kept this in 5 minutes, and I will try and do another 5 minute Friday next week. Well, I hope you got something out of that and it was helpful to you. Until my next video, it's bye from me, and it's goodbye from me.